you right here, because you must understand that worship and praise to God is never based upon how you feel. Your praise, when your hands go up to God, it should never be because of how you feel. Look, David said, I will bless the Lord. You've heard it before. That's why it doesn't bless you. But he says, I'll bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. I was speaking to one of my preachers this morning, and I said to her, you must understand that when we praise God, my praise to God should never be on the basis of how I feel. It should always be on the basis of what I know. But the problem is, that's too much emotionalism in church. Our reaction to God is based upon how we feel. That's why some of us can only join in when a certain song is being sang. That's why some of us can only join in when a certain preacher is in the pulpit. It's because it's a whole lot of emotionalism instead of knowledge-based worship. That's why I hear the Lord said, he says, Brian, it's going to take knowledge-based worship. In other words, you're going to have something that will hold you together when your feelings abandon you. Because the truth of the matter is, you will admit you can't trust your feelings. Somebody said, sometimes I feel like a nut, and then sometimes I don't. And God is looking for somebody. He said, the hour has come and the time is now. He said, the Father seeketh such to worship him. He says, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in the truth. Now I would have had some compassion upon you if he says, they that worship him must worship him in spirit, truth, and feeling. But he didn't say spirit, truth, and feeling. He says, ignore your feelings and praise me because of what you know about me. What that means is, even when you're sick in your body, you can still praise him because you know he's a healer, not because you feel healed. Oh, y'all not gonna help me. Even when there is no provision in your house, you can still praise God for provision, even when your provision has not been produced, because you're praising him based upon what you know about him. Tell your neighbor, just because your bills are due doesn't mean God's not a provider. Sometimes God wants some good works in a bad situation. Oh, I said sometimes God wants some good works in a bad. Some of y'all, Lord, if you deliver me, Lord, I promise. Some of y'all making resolutions right now, Lord, if you just deliver me, 2009 gonna be your year. Now God said, no, I'm not gonna wait until 2009. God said, oh no, you got about 16 days to do good in 2008. If your 2008 has been wicked, it's been sinful, it's been lazy, it's been faithless, he said you got about 15 more days to do better. God said, do good where you are. Sometimes you got to do good while you're being talked bad to. I'm coming down your street. Sometimes you got to do good while you're being mistreated. Sometimes you got to do good while you're being lied on. Sometimes, do it right there. It don't take much strength to do good when nothing's going wrong. It takes strength to do good when all hell has broken loose. God, I hear the Lord says, he said, Brian, tell them I'm not going to move them. It's not because I'm not concerned about their situation. He said, but I'm not going to move them. Because mother, he said, I need a witness in that situation. He said, because what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to raise you up so that I can get a witness to your enemy. He said, because I come that you have life and have it more abundantly. He said, we are more than conquerors. Now, what's the difference between a conqueror and more than a conqueror? Now, a conqueror is one who kills his enemy dead. But more than a conqueror is one who makes his enemy to be your friend. So God says, when I bring you out, I'm not necessarily going to disconnect you from your enemy. But I'm going to use you to get your enemy saved. He says, so when you come out, you ain't coming out by yourself. Look at somebody and tell them, say, neighbor, I'm satisfied right here. Because when God brings me out, that's going to be a paradigm shift. Oh, I could preach right here, but stay there. It's uncomfortable, but stay there. It's painful, but stay there. Your heart is breaking, but stay there. Because God is up to something. We sing Zion. Oh, I'm going to preach now. They said, how can we sing Zion songs in a
strange land. Evangelist Penn, I don't preach that text like most preachers, because I got mad at the Israelites, because the Bible said they had hung their harps in the willows. In other words, my friend, they were looking at their praise, but wouldn't praise him. They were watching people rejoice, but wouldn't join in. They said, what do you mean? I can't sing Zion songs in a strange land. What's wrong with you, fool? The best time to praise God is in a strange land. The best time to lift him up when nobody else is lifting him up. Y'all don't impress me when you start jumping and shouting because everybody else is jumping and shouting. I want to know, what do you do on your job when you're the only one saved there? What do you do in your home? What do you do to step out of fear? Look at somebody and say, neighbor, if God has delivered you, then why should you be bound? If God has delivered you, then untie your money, untie your heart, untie, untie. Tell your neighbor, take the limits off of God. Take the limits off of God. Because the Bible says in the last day, the righteous shall be full of plenty. Come over here. The table is spread, and the feast of the Lord is going on. There is joy over here. There is peace over here. Look at somebody that said, neighbor, come out of fear. Come out of fear, because the Lord shall provide. All of your needs according to your riches in glory. Tell somebody, I'm going to sow my way into provision. I'm going to sow my way in the healing. I'm going to sow my way into promotion. Yes, because God has not given me a spirit of fear, but power, love. I got power to give, power to love, power to heal, power. God, whoa, is not through blessing you. Oh, oh, the devil. Do y'all believe that? Oh, the devil is a liar. I don't care what he told you. I don't care how he's coming against you. Oh, 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 the devil is a liar. And God deceived. Deceive, deceive unto you.